Good afternoon, everyone, and welcome to this year's Advent Music Festival. It's a service filled with music that worships God during this holy season. And I personally want to thank Jonathan Block and the choir for all their work putting this together today. It's going to be a very meaningful time of worship. Just a note that during the service, Christina Hammes is going to be streaming our service onto Facebook just from here over. So right now I'm talking on Facebook about that. So just a note. And at this time I'd like to invite Diana Stanton to come forward with a few words.
Good afternoon. We're so glad that you're here today, and we have just had a really great year with our Zion Choir, and at this time I'd like John Block to come up. We always truly appreciate his musicianship and his great sense of humor, and you know, like the song we're going to sing later, something like Run to the Manger, Manger, and things like that. So here's just a little token of our appreciation for him.
Oh, thank you. Thank you very much. Oh, my.
Thank you.
First scripture reading today takes us into the book of Jeremiah, during a time when the Israelites were experiencing a very difficult time. Jeremiah spoke these words about the prophecy of the coming of our Lord. He wrote in chapter 33, 14 through 16, "The days are surely coming, says the Lord, when I will fulfill the promise I made to the house of Israel and the house of Judah. In those days and at that time I will cause a righteous branch to spring up for David, and he shall execute justice and righteousness in the land. In those days Judah will be saved, and Jerusalem will live in safety. And this is the name by which it will be called: the Lord is our righteousness." Our second scripture reading today is from the first chapter of the Gospel of Luke. And here is a part of the story just after Mary, the mother of our Lord, finds out that she's pregnant with Jesus. She quickly travels to her cousin Elizabeth's home to tell her of the news. And we read in verse 39, "In those days Mary set out and went with haste to a Judean town in the hill country, where she entered the house of Zechariah and greeted Elizabeth. When Elizabeth heard Mary's greeting, the child leapt in her womb, and Elizabeth was filled with the Holy Spirit and exclaimed with a loud cry, 'Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb. And why has this happened to me, that the mother of my Lord comes to me? For as soon as I heard the sound of your greeting, the child in my womb leapt for joy. And blessed is she who believed that there would be a fulfillment of what was spoken to her by the Lord.' And Mary said, 'My soul magnifies the Lord, and my spirit rejoices in God my Savior. For he has looked with favor on the lowliness of his servant. Surely from now on all generations will call me blessed, for the Mighty One has done great things for me, and holy is his name. His mercy is for those who fear him from generation to generation. He has shown strength with his arm. He has scattered the proud in the thoughts of their hearts. He has brought down the powerful from their thrones and lifted up the lowly. He has filled the hungry with good things and sent the rich away empty. He has helped his servant Israel in remembrance of his mercy, according to the promise he made to our ancestors, to Abraham and to his descendants forever.' And Mary remained with her about 3 months and then returned to her home."
Amen.
next reading this afternoon comes from the Gospel according to St. Luke. And here we travel to the night of Christ's birth itself, when angels appeared to shepherds on the hillside, announcing the birth of our Lord. We read in chapter 2, verse 8, "In that region there were shepherds living in the fields, keeping watch over their flock by night. An angel of the Lord stood before them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, 'Do not be afraid, for see, I am bringing you good news of great joy for all the people. To you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, who is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign for you. You will find a child wrapped in bands of cloth and lying in a manger.' And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host, praising God and saying, 'Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth peace among those whom he favors.'"
Thank you.
Well, our last reading today is from the Gospel according to St. Matthew. It's the arrival of the wise men to see Jesus. Because these wise men brought three gifts, later church tradition added the detail that there were three of them who came to see Jesus. In reality, the story doesn't tell us how many there were. There could have been three, there could have been 30. And there's more likely there were more because they were traveling a long distance. But regardless, as this group of astrologers arrived, this is what happened in chapter 2, verse 1. In the time of King Herod, after Jesus was born in Bethlehem of Judea, wise men from the east came to Jerusalem, asking, "Where is the child who has been born King of the Jews? For we observed his star at its rising, and have come to pay him homage." When King Herod heard this, he was frightened, and all Jerusalem with him. And calling together all the chief priests and scribes of the people, he inquired of them where the Messiah was to be born. They told him, "In Bethlehem of Judea, for so it has been written by the prophet, 'And you, Bethlehem, in the land of Judah, are by no means least among the rulers of Judah, for from you shall come a ruler who is to shepherd my people, Israel.' Then Herod secretly called for the wise men and learned from them the exact time when the star had appeared. Then he sent them to Bethlehem, saying, 'Go and search diligently for the child, and when you found him, bring word, so that I may also go and pay him homage.' When they had heard the king, they set out, and there ahead of them went the star that they had seen at its rising, until it stopped over the place where the child was. When they saw that the star had stopped, they were overwhelmed with joy. On entering the house, they saw the child with Mary, his mother, and they knelt down and they paid him homage. Then opening their treasure chests, they offered him gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh. And having been warned in a dream not to return to Herod, they left for their own country by another road."
Never have I. Thank you.
May God bless us as we take this worshipful spirit into a world and sing praises through our lives to the Lord. Amen.